History is made again as the Philippines marks its first ever win in the World Cup. The Filipinas outlasted co-host New Zealand 1-0 with Serena Bolden giving the Philippines the winning goal at the 24th minute. The Filipinas are the first debut team to score in the World Cup. They now have one win and one loss, keeping their round of 16 bid alive. They are set to face world number 12 Norway on Saturday in the next group stage match. The Philippine Transportation Department vows to speed up infrastructure projects to help push economic activity in the country. Transportation Secretary Jaime Bautista notes the agency is echoing President Marcos' statement in his State of the Nation address that infrastructure development will help drive the economy. Bautista added, apart from the railway projects the government had already initiated, several other projects such as the Metro Manila subway are also underway. He also cited some crucial airport projects such as the NAIA privatization and the New Manila International Airport in Bulacan. The planned three-day transport strike in the Philippines suspended amid the threat posed by EGAI. But Transport Group Manibela said the strike will continue if government fails to address issues faced by the sector. Manibela started the strike Monday to denounce government's public utility vehicle modernization program. The protest coincided with the president's second State of the Nation address, but he did not touch on issues related to transportation. Super Typhoon EGAI maintains its strength as it continues to threaten northern Luzon. The province of Cagayan is already being battered by heavy rains and strong winds. Evacuation is expected to be conducted in several coastal barangays. Residents also told to brace for flash floods and landslides. The Department of Social Welfare and Development already preparing food packs and other forms of aid for Cagayan. EGAI has also forced the cancellation of trips in dozens of ports in Luzon and the Visayas, leaving hundreds of passengers stranded, particularly in Cebu, Calabarzon, and Mimaropa.
Repower Energy Development Corporation marks a successful debut at the Philippine Stock Exchange. The renewable energy firm raised over 1 billion pesos from its initial public offering on Monday, the proceeds of which will be used by the company to partially fund two mini hydroelectric power plants as well as to develop and acquire renewable projects. Repower closed up nearly 1% on its first trading day. Now today's shares are trading 0.2% lower. Now for some local corporate stories, Pure Gold's profits in the first half of the year fell flat as inflationary pressure on margins and expenses offset strong sales. The Lucio-Co-led company's net income was up 5% year-on-year to 4.4 billion pesos, while revenues grew 11% to 91.2 billion. Pure Gold notes its top-line growth will stay buoyant for the rest of the year. In contrast, the first half of the year was a sweet spot for imported liquor distributor The Keepers Holdings. It booked a 1.16 billion peso net income in the said period, up 18% from last year. Revenues also up 19% to 6.5 billion pesos. The company points to strong sales of imported brandy, wines, and specialty beverages for its business growth. Meanwhile, Atlas Mining's income declines by more than half of a percent in H1. Now, the company says its net income was down to 803 million pesos from 2 billion pesos last year. Its revenues, though, climbed 4% to over 10 billion pesos. The company's performance due from lower copper prices as well as weaker production. A business group highly satisfied with President Marcos's second State of the Nation address, the Makati Business Club says Marcos's speech was very straightforward and businesslike. The group's executive director, Coco Alcuas, adds government is focused on economic recovery, gives comfort to the business sector. He notes, though, there are some points that Marcos could have addressed during his accomplishment report.
We did miss from the SONA mention of the proposed PPP Act and also amendments to the right-of-way law. Both of these are, we think, very highly essential in order to get public-private partnerships and infrastructure in general moving. The other thing that he didn't mention, which this government and previous governments have mentioned, is the lifting of the bank secrecy law. With two other bills or two other proposals, an FOI or Freedom of Information law, and also the strengthening of the SAL-N law. We believe that these three together can really address the anti-corruption angle of the president.
The Management Association of the Philippines also saying Marcos missed a lot of pressing issues during his SONA, but its Vice President, Attorney Alex Cabrera, gave a passing score to the administration.
I would say that there are many also important things which were not tackled, mm-hmm. and I couldn't miss out on the corruption, mm-hmm. Being one of those issues. 67% of the CEOs believe that corruption could be a hindrance to the progress of this nation. And the president not tackling corruption as an issue among its priority areas, I think that's very important for the president to miss. And very close to this is the Freedom of Information Bill, mm-hmm. Which was also not tackled as a priority bill. In fact, not one of those mentioned during the SONA. Mm-hmm. And I think it's also very important to mention initiatives on human rights, mm-hmm. for instance. And the fact that the government is no longer entertaining the ICC, mm-hmm. Investigations can also indicate, the track of the government on where human rights violations or dealing with human rights violations are headed.
Philippine economic managers gave a briefing a day after President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. touted economic achievements during his second State of the Nation address. Our correspondent, Jackie Pascual, is on the line to tell us more. Hi, Jackie.
Hi, good afternoon, Stanley. Economic managers of the Philippine government vowed to continue curbing inflation following the State of the Nation address of President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. The president has mentioned in his SONA that the biggest challenge of his administration is inflation, which peaked at 8.7% earlier this year, the highest in 14 years. At the post-SONA Philippine economic briefing earlier, National Economic and Development Authority Secretary Arsenio Balisacan asserted that inflation rate is decelerating now, even hitting already 5.4% in June. He admitted, though, that prices of some products remain elevated, but some have already decreased. Government needs to improve production and lessen transport costs to lower prices, he said. The Philippine Chamber of Commerce and Industry President George Barcelon said that logistics is a major problem in the country and that leads to high cost of goods. And as Balisacan mentioned earlier, that they need to improve roads and farm-to-market roads so that your transport costs could be lower, which in effect could also lower prices of food. But for SM Investments Corporation Vice Chairman Tessie C. Coson, she said the issue of inflation is mostly because of external factors. And she admitted that it's tough to fight inflation in the country because, as she said, the Philippines is just one of the countries in the whole world that is also affected by inflation. The Banco Central ng Pilipinas said the target inflation by the end of the year is about 2 to 4%. BSP Deputy Governor Dakila mentioned also that they might or they remain watchful and remains ready to resume monetary tightenings if needed. And that's the latest. Stanley, back to you.
All right. Thank you so much for the update, Jackie Pascual.